It's too sad even for me. I'm only gonna do that again to where I don't have to explain the context, this other song, but this one is pretty darn sad. That's why you're here, right? That's the thing. He was a happy-go-lucky guy, really, when you get down to it. About half the folks in here knew him, really. So I don't have to tell you that. This is a very especially dramatic day. We're about to fly out from New Orleans. And I think maybe because of Lucinda Williams' songs, like, find out where Lake Pontchartrain came from. It's one of the better lake names in country music. And we did happen to find it. It wasn't that far from the airport, so we went there and filled it at the time. My lovely girlfriend Veronica and I. Actually, pretty nice names. Call back. Oh wait, I'm not a stand-up. Sorry, I get confused. I watch some of my stand-up comedy. But so we were hanging out there, taking a walk, kind of getting little jitters out before taking the flight back. We weren't sure if he was going to be with us at the time we came back. That was it was sort of a cinematic drama to the whole thing. And I was a little bit too worked up to write the song, but like I sometimes do, I kind of came back to it. I fixed my mind on what the feeling of that day was half a year later or something, and I wrote this tune called Red Line Sky. Also, the day he turned 64, it's not that long after. I gave him a print of that. Say thanks for sharing his love of photography with me. In nature itself.
Right now.
his dad's glasses a couple days after Boston. Got him somewhere up here.
Right here.
Like his,
You want them?
No, it's okay. I like having these, I think all of you probably know. Maybe you probably know somebody, but at a certain point, you got to decide what to keep, and you just can't keep everything because you have to get a couple storage units. But I like to get a couple of things that really are especially iconic. So I like seeing dad's glasses every day. And this photo represents the song we're going to skip because it's a little too much. And so from here, we're going to do the tune. Not exactly like itself, but it's the tune that we did at his memorial in June. And a lot of my friends were saying really nice things about this song after they heard it for the first time. So this is you can do your mannequin thing if you want to. Or, dancer or whatever. I'm gonna tune for a second. You guys got any jokes?
Not that I want to tell any jokes.
Alright, after I said that, I'm like, oh wait, I asked that one guy.
Righteous,
do you have any jokes? Daniel?
Fun fact about Dad, he took a stand-up class. It was a little known and very proud bucket list thing for him.
When did he do that?
Oh gosh, maybe 15 years ago.
Wow.
He really appreciated comedy, and he was so sarcastic. We all knew him for that.
I'm not at all like him. Speaking of which, well, I'm a lot like him. With the jitteriness of our mom mixed in there, I think, for good measure.
So this place is an art center now, right? Years ago, I took a pottery class at a free pottery class. I heard about it from my mom, heard about it on the radio, so I called up, made an appointment, and signed up for this class. And I got there, nobody was there yet. So they gave me a big lump of clay. I started making a thing that looked like the pyramids. I kind of looked like a pyramid, the first chunk I had. So I made these little guys and little ropes and bricks and things being moved around. The glass filled up. And after a while, I looked up, and across from me was a young woman making something that looked like a duck. And next to her was a guy making something that looked like a dog's head. And as I looked around the room, I realized that everybody was blind. So, just then the teacher came along and said, I've never seen anybody do anything like this in my class before. And I said, oh, thank you, I've been doing this for a little while. And where's the bathroom? And she told me, and I stood up, put my hand on the wall. Walked out of the room, walked out of the building, and I never went back. So always make sure when you sign up for free things at art centers, for a specific population.
That's what we charge today. In case that has to happen again. Here's a tune we wrote for, had a couple of days, sometimes, I guess just some writing, so it might be good sometimes to have a deadline. If you're a little bit scattered, like I am. So I wrote this in between the passage and the memorial.
Maybe it's right on that. Everything about wash away.